It was coming up to Christmas time on the island of Sodor, and everybody was very happy and jolly at this time of year. All the engines have special jobs taking passengers and goods to festive events all over the island. All the engines enjoy this time of year. One day, Thomas was at Ellsbridge when Gordon pulled in.
Oh, Thomas, how are we today on your little line?
It's good as always, Gordon. It's just I gotta wear that annoying snowplow soon. You know how much I hate that.
I know. There's even talk of us mainline engines having to wear them too.
You will look silly. And you can't go fast wearing them. You'll be as slow as James on a slow goods.
Laughed Thomas.
Oh, the indignity.
Thomas watched Gordon steam away. He then saw Percy come running in out of control.
Help! I'm out of control!
Thomas saw the trucks behind Percy laughing as they pushed him along. What shocked Thomas more was the fact no one was on Percy's footplate.
Percy! Station Master, call up the line. Tell them to get help.
The Station Master went to the phone. Thomas unfortunately had to go with his passengers. When he got to the next station, the Station Master was waiting.
Thomas, I have some bad news. Percy has come off the line and has split his saddle tank. He will be out of action at the works for a few days. Ryan is coming to help us till Percy is repaired.
Oh, poor Percy. Is his crew okay?
Yes, the trucks bumped Percy when they stopped at a signal box. The guard and driver were in the box and the fireman was looking out of the cab. He was knocked off the footplate, but he'll be fine. Thomas just looked sad and headed off down the line. A few days later, it was Christmas Eve and Thomas was pulling a nativity special into Knapford. This special was for all the churches to send people from their congregation to the large church in Knapford for a midnight nativity play. As he pulled in, he heard Sir Topham Hatt on the phone in his office.
I'm going to have to shut the Ffarqhuar line. Yes, yes, now wait. How much for the repairs?
Thomas didn't get to hear any more before his driver had uncoupled him and ran him into the sheds. All the engines there saw how concerned he was.
What's wrong, Thomas?
I heard today Sir Topham Hatt saying that he's going to be closing my branch line down.
Closing your branch line? But why?
Ha ha ha! Probably because you've been leaving your coaches behind again and refusing to wear your snowplough. Ha ha ha!
Oh, the guard!
Well, perhaps you've been falling down too many mines.
You all think it's funny, don't you? Well, I don't. What's going to happen to Annie and Clarabelle?
Thomas was so angry that his driver decided to find somewhere for him to calm down, but Thomas had other plans. They waited in the station for the return run of the special. As he chuffed around the island, all he could think about was losing the branch line.
What's going to happen to Toby, Percy and Daisy? Poor Mavis. She just started travelling down the line too.
When they dropped the last vicar off at Maithwaite that night, Thomas made his move. He bumped the controls. He ran down his branch line and went into a siding near the old mine. It was cold and dark, and he didn't have enough steam left to move for a while. His driver and fireman were not happy. "You silly engine, you can stay here tonight now then. We are going home." And they left him in the mine. It was cold and dark in the sidings. Thomas felt the wind blow around his cooling boiler and in between his frames.
"Psst! Here! You! Blue engine!
Who's there?"
"It's me, Glyn. Who are you?"
"I'm Thomas. I run this branch line."
"Ah, you're Thomas. I used to run this line before you came. Then I was placed here to shunt when the mine reopened. I saw you fall into the mines. You ruined that chance for me to be useful again."
"I am sorry. I didn't mean to."
"Oh, it's fine. I've had plenty of time to think about things, and I've forgiven you. What's got you so down to the dumps?"
"Well, Sir Topham, the man who runs the railway, is thinking of closing the branch line down. He was talking on the phone when I heard him. I don't know what I could do without the branch line. It's my pride and joy."
"Oh, I'm sure there's more to it than that, Thomas."
"No. He definitely said it was shutting down. I'm worried for my friends. One's in the works for a busted tank. I should have been on that goods train, but we swapped so I could take Annie and Clarabelle out. I wish I hadn't. I would have been able to control them."
"What do you mean?"
"I have learnt a lot about trucks over the years. If I had done as I was told, Percy wouldn't need a new saddle tank, and the Fat Controller wouldn't have to shut my line to pay for it."
"Did he say that's why he's closing the line?"
"Does it matter? It's all my fault. I wish I never came to Sodor in the first place. Maybe then the railway would have enough money."
"Oh my Thomas, you should never wish such a thing."
"Well, I do."
"Oh, well. You know what they say."
Glyn's eyes started to glow.
Be careful what you wish for. It may just come true.
When Thomas woke up, it was morning. He looked around but couldn't see Glynn anywhere. Then he noticed that the line was repaired.
What's going on? Glynn?
Just then, he heard Glynn's voice.
Welcome, Thomas, to the island of Sodor, where you never came here.
Well, it doesn't look or feel any different to... I'm in my old brown livery!
You didn't come to Sodor, so you're in a very painted blue. And you don't wear the number one either.
Thomas was shocked. He felt a fire deep in his firebox.
Oh, good. My driver and fireman came back. Now, driver, can we go, please?
But no one answered. Thomas wanted to move and found he did. Yet he didn't feel his regulator open.
That's odd. Must be my old regulator. Before they tightened it after I crashed into the station master's house.
So Thomas went back out onto his branch line. He looked around thinking nothing had changed. Then Diesel came up the other line with some trucks.
Out of my way, you stinky old steamy.
Thomas was shocked. He watched Diesel go by.
He doesn't have to be so rude.
Then Thomas got another surprise.
Daisy? Oh, thank Billington you're around. Why is Diesel on our branch line?
Our line? How dare you? This is my branch line. And who are you, and what business do you have on my line?
I'm Thomas, and I work with you, remember?
Well, I've never heard of you, Thomas, and you don't work here now. You steam engines are all old and dated, just like those rubbish coaches, Annie and Clarabelle. Thank goodness we got rid of those years ago.
Annie and Clarabelle! They're gone!
You see, because you don't exist, Annie and Clarabelle were never taken out for a very long time. Their upkeep cost a lot of money, and Daisy never wanted them, so they had no choice but to...
Scrap them?
No, no, they didn't scrap them! They were sent over to Brighton Beach and converted into beach huts.
Thomas was devastated. When the signal changed to green, he set off down the line again. Parts he remembered seemed to be different, but he couldn't place it somehow. Others, it was dreadfully obvious.
Leaf weight is shut.
Yep. Without any Clarabelle, and just Daisy running passenger services, you had to shut most of the branch line stations down. She's effectively known as a ghost train.
She's a ghost?
No, literally, Thomas, it's a saying with the network rail. It's a train that services only runs once or twice a day, and the line is virtually empty.
Network rail?
Glynn explained to Thomas that the track was owned by a company called Network Rail, who looked after the lines and signals. The Northwestern Railway Company only ran the trains.
Oh, so the Fat Controller still runs the company.
We'll see, Thomas.
Ah, good morning, Gordon. Was Thomas at the sheds last night?
Yes, sir, he was. But we didn't see him after he took his special back. He was very upset.
Upset? Why?
He said you were talking about shutting down his branch line.
What? Oh no, he must have heard me. I was closing it for repairs.
That explains why he was so upset. And we teased him for it.
Just then, Edward pulls in.
Toby said Thomas never came back to the sheds last night.
Edward, Gordon, please tell all the engines to be on the lookout for him. He has to be around the island somewhere.
Meanwhile, Thomas was on the mainline heading towards Knapford. He was shocked to see Pip and Emma twice.
They must be really quick.
Or there is more of them. See?
Glynn was right. Two more high-speed trains ran past him.
Oh!
As they rounded a corner, they saw a familiar black engine sat in a field.
James! Is that you?
Who are you? How do you know me?
We're old friends. What happened? I thought I saved you from this field.
Oh, I wish you had. But one day many years back, I had a nasty crash when my brake box caught fire and the trucks pushed me down the hill and into this field. No engine was available to get me out for days, and by the time they tried to lift me, I was beyond repair. The price of having proper brakes was too high for such a mark at the top of my head. So he found much better use for me. He saw me and the farmer made me the scarecrow.
See, you were never there to rescue James from that field and... Now look where he is.
No. No, 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 this isn't right. I'm going to Knapford to talk to Sir Topham Hatt about this.
Go right ahead then.
James! James! We need to keep an eye out for Thomas. He didn't go back to his sheds at Tidmouth last night.
He didn't. That's not like him.
Please tell as many engines as you see to look out for him.
Of course I will. I hope he's okay.
Thomas steamed along angrily to Knapford. He kept seeing diesels all over the island.
The Fat Controller would never get rid of steam.
Thomas kept reminding himself. As he got to Knapford, he saw the diesels working around the station. Boko was pulling the express, Paxton was shunting another set of coaches, and another big diesel that Thomas didn't know took the local.
Where are all my friends?
He asked sadly. He pulled into an empty platform where he saw a man walk out of the Fat Controller's office.
Excuse me, sir, but I'd like to speak to Sir Topham Hatt. Where is he?
What? That plump old fuddy-daddy. He was sacked a few years back by the board. I run the line now. I am Norman Spencer.
Why was he sacked?
Thomas asked, shocked. His fire seemed to get colder with that news.
He wouldn't merge with BR and go along with the modernization plan. His steam engines cost the railway too much money. Most were finally sent for scrap, sold at a loss to Heritage Lines, or went to the museums. Now Sodor can live happily in the 21st century. It's just like I say, new things are better than the old.
How dare you say that about steam engines? We will always be more useful and reliable than your new diesel engines.
Don't talk back to me, engine. Now get off my railway and go to those silly little heritage lines.
Norman walked off. Thomas sat for a while sad. Glynn spoke up.
You see, Thomas, without you coming to the island, Edward had to keep doing the shunting in the yard.
So, you mean...
That's right. Brendan Branch never reopened either. And as a tender engine is more costly to run than a tank engine, he was soon replaced by Eddie.
But Thomas still hadn't lost hope just yet, and decided to go check the sheds. As he arrived, he saw it had been replaced by a horrid-looking building.
What is this?
The new diesel motive depot.
But where does Gordon, Henry or Emily live?
They're at the National Collection in York.
Thomas was distraught.
All my friends are gone. Percy! He should be at the works, getting his tank fixed.
Oh, my pistons. Oh, hello, Percy. What are you doing here?
I derailed and split my tank. You?
One of my pistons is leaking steam.
I had that once. It wasn't pleasant.
Just then, Henry pulls in.
Percy, Thomas is missing.
Missing?
Oh, dear.
Yes, so Tom Hatt has sent me with some metal sheets to get you patched up as soon as possible so you can join the search.
Thank you, Henry. Workmen, can you fix me up now? Was that Thomas?
Thomas was on his way to Croven's Gate. When they got to Croven's Gate, Thomas was shocked to see the Scarlow Railway's main station was now a museum, and the line had been taken up and turned into roads. A smirking steamroller stood at the museum, as well as Scarlow and Reneas.
Where's Peter Sam and Sir Handel?
Who? It's just been us two for years.
Thomas sadly puffed into the works. He saw Percy sat in the siding in steam and with his tanks repaired.
Percy? Oh, Percy! How glad I am to see you!
Another steam engine on Sodor? Brilliant. Have you come to shut the works for me?
Oh, Percy. What have they done to you?
Saved me from being scrapped. That's what they've done to me. Who are you, anyway?
But do you remember me? Thomas?
No. No. Should I?
Yes. We're best friends. We used to run the Ffarqhuar branch together.
A branch line? I never ran a branch line. I came here to shut the station, but was placed in the works instead. Now, please go away if you don't need repair. I have a 45 to get into the painting department.
But Percy, I'm your best friend, Thomas.
I have no best friend. Now go away or I'll have to get the foreman.
Thomas sadly left the works. He trundled sadly along the island, and then he heard a diesel approaching from behind, and an unmistakable pinching noise.
Look, Pinchy, it's that steam engine I've heard about running along the line.
Oh no! Diesel turn!
Where did you get to?
Good morning on this fine Christmas day, Edward. You seem down in the scrub today.
It's Thomas Dieseltan. He's missing.
Missing? Oh dear. That's not good at all. All the kids love seeing him at this Christmas party.
I know, but I can't do anything when we still have jobs to do.
I hope he has found some.
Thomas was still being chased by Diesel 10.
Help! Help! Someone save me!
As he approached the Brendam line, a signalman saw him coming. This man liked steam more than diesels and quickly sent him down the old branch and sent Diesel 10 further down the main line.
Oh, that was close. It's the Brendam line. Boy, does it look run down.
He said sadly. As he rounded a corner, he saw the scrapyard and Edward sitting in the pile.
Oh, Edward. Whatever happened to you?
Oh, hello there, little engine. I became too old and expensive, and there was no more work for me available at Natford, as I was replaced by diesels. So, I was sent here and will be broken up when they find the right time.
Oh, Edward, that is horrible. And, wait, that's not...
Terence the tractor. He broke down and the farmers sold him for a newer one. Apparently, Caterpillar trucks aren't good for farms.
But it can't be. He saved me from that snowdrift.
You never got in a snowdrift, Thomas. You didn't come to the island. And because he didn't save you, the farmer didn't keep him.
Thomas looked sad and puffed up the line some more.
When he got to the docks, he saw them empty. The China clay pits had shut down some years ago as well.
Without Edward to deliver the goods, the clay pits just fell into debt and eventually they closed.
Just then, Thomas heard a diesel engine.
Ah, why did that steamy go? I know it's around here somewhere.
Oh no, I need to hide.
Thomas moved around the harbour. He watched Diesel 10 use his arms to set points for himself. Thomas managed to work his way back onto the branch line and headed towards the main line.
Aha! I've got you now, Puffball!
Thomas gasped in surprise and ran as quickly as he could.
You can't outwit me, Smokebox!
Thomas! 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 Oh, Thomas, where are you?
Thomas raced along the tracks and managed to get back onto his old branch line. He went as fast as he could, whistling at signal boxes for help.
Someone save me!
Standing on a bridge, he saw someone familiar. A small man in a top hat.
Sir Topham! Help!
Thomas called as he raced under a bridge. He didn't see the man jump in his car and drive off. Thomas got nearer the mine sidings.
I can hide in there.
He saw the man in the hat change the points for him. Thomas slammed on his brakes, coming to a stop just short of the danger sign.
Phew. That was close.
He heard Diesel 10 go past the mine, laughing like a maniac.
Oh, Glenn, help me. Please help me. I want my life back. I want everything back the way it was. Oh, please, get me out of this awful place. Please, please, please.
Oh, Thomas, thank goodness. Are you all right?
Oh, Terence, it's awful.
What's awful?
Wait. You know me. And you're not in the scrapyard. And my blue pen work is back. Woohoo!
Terence couldn't understand, but wasn't too bothered, really. He was just happy his friend Thomas was all right.
Oh, what day is it, Terence? Is Toby and Percy still running the line? Is Gordon and Henry at Knapford?
It's Christmas Day, Thomas. Everyone on Sodor has been looking for you. Apparently your driver and fireman forgot to tell anyone where you were, and they got so drunk last night with the festivities, they forgot.
Really? Wait. Christmas Day?
He looks round at the snow.
Of course! There was no snow in the other Sodor.
Other Sodor?
It's a long story. Merry Christmas, Terence.
Merry Christmas, Thomas. Wait here and I'll go and get the others.
Thomas was happy to see Terence. He sighed with relief.
Well, Thomas, do you regret that wish?
Thomas looked over at Glynn in shock, then in anger.
What did you do to me?
Glynn just started to laugh.
Hypnotism, my friend. I've had many years of practice on a deer or two.
Thomas started to laugh too. After 10 minutes, he heard a familiar whistle.
Thomas, what are you doing here?
Percy, you're fixed.
Yes, he was patched up while his new tank is made to help find you. Now why did you come to the mine?
I came to hide, sir. I heard you on the phone. We were talking about shutting down the branch line.
For bridge repairs, Thomas. The Elsbridge viaduct was inspected the other day and it was found to be cracking. With the work that's needed, I can't have that bridge opened.
So that means the branch would be closed until the bridge is repaired.
Exactly, Thomas. It's too risky to run trains over the bridge.
Thomas relaxed.
Sorry, sir. I jumped to conclusions.
So you did. Now then, a crew is on its way to steam you up, and Glynn, you're still here?
Ah, Topham, you remember me.
Of course I do. How can I forget my first engine?
Cause you've got other favourites, apparently.
Thomas and Percy looked confused.
Glynn here was the first steam engine I ever worked on. I started as a cleaner at 15, then became his fireman, then his driver. I sent him to this mine to save him, but the paperwork got lost.
Well, can we take him to the works to mend him?
Oh, that would be splendid!
Only if he doesn't hypnotise me again.
Hypnotise you?
It's a long story, sir.
And Thomas started to tell them as Percy buffered up to Thomas and they collected Glynn. By the time Thomas had steamed up, he was nearing the end of his tale.
And then I woke up here. And you know the rest.
Did you really wish you never came here?
Yes. I was very upset.
Well, I'm glad you were only hypnotized and not actually removed from the island. You're my best friend, and I can't imagine not having you as a friend, Thomas.
Thomas smiled as he headed back to Knapford where the other engines were gathered for a large Christmas party.
Thank you. Gordon! Henry! James! Edward! You're all right too!
The four big engines looked confused.
I am sorry I got angry last night. I misunderstood something I heard.
You being okay, Thomas? You haven't been yourself recently.
With Percy's accident the other day, I began to think it was my fault as we swapped jobs. It just got me thinking about all the other times it may have been my fault.
Accidents happen, Thomas. It's no one's fault. You should know that by now.
Oh, I do, Edward. Glynn showed me that.
Glynn? You're still on the island, old friend.
You all right, Edward? What's occurring? It's been a few years.
Just a few. Well, nice to see you again.
The Fat Controller interrupted the engines.
Ladies and gentlemen in engines, I am happy to say not only did we find Thomas this morning, but we also found a very old dear friend too. I will see where I can put Glynn to work once he's been overhauled. Now back to today's big event, Christmas. I would just like to say a huge thank you to all you engines. This year has been one of our best, with new friends joining us and some old ones returning. These past few years have been a bit rough on the island, but we are starting to pull back now. To the staff as well, thank you for your continued service here. As a present, a bonus has been dropped into your pay packets. Now to the good part. As the CEO and controller of the Northwestern Railway, I would like to wish you all a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Merry Christmas
and a Happy New Year!
Happy New Year!
The engines erupted in a chorus of whistles, bells and horns, and everyone cheered the Fat Controller. Thomas smiled happily and looked at Glynn.
Thank you, Glynn. If it wasn't for you, I wouldn't have realised how important I've been on the island, and my friends, and how much I needed them too.
It's no problem, Thomas. I'm glad you have figured that out, though. I learned that many years ago, friends will always be there when you need them most. I saw that with you and Gordon, and today with Percy and Terence.
I hope we can be friends.
Of course. Merry Christmas, Thomas.
Merry Christmas, Glynn.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas, everyone.